I'm Richard O'Brien. I'm an emergency physician, originally from New York City, but I adopted my hometown of Washington, D.C., where I went to medical school. I went into medicine because of my own family doctor about second grade. I needed my tonsils out, and he got me into the hospital, and he visited me so many times, and he was so good to my own family, and I thought, what a great profession, what a great thing to do. And I always ran away from him when he had a needle. I went to Georgetown University as an undergrad. I liked it so much there, I applied early decision to Georgetown University School of Medicine. I was lucky. They took me, so I had a pretty easy senior year undergrad. And then 4 years at Georgetown Medical School, and then I came up here to practice. I went to Danville for residency, Geisinger, and I did the emergency medicine residency there and loved it. I fell in love with emergency medicine because I liked the idea that I could take care of anyone that rolled, walked, or even was dragged through my door. The first few minutes of any medical case whatsoever, I learned how to treat. I've been involved with pre-hospital medicine, that's EMTs and paramedics, for a good 30 years almost. I think pretty close to 30 years. And I started teaching at LCCC, which is a local community college, in their paramedic program for the joy of doing it. And I've risen to the point of being the medical director. And that's been a very, very, very fulfilling thing to do for me. And it's also helped me teach medical students. I teach because it's the most fun I have professionally. I love to see their eyes open up when students just realize that when you put an apple here and a pear there, you have fruit. They take the consequences of their actions medically, they take the consequences of their actions socially and physically, and they make themselves into practicing physicians. It's just a wonderful thing to follow. It's a wonderful thing to watch. It's a wonderful thing to help out. I've had the students shadow me in my practice. I've had the students assist me in my practice. I like doing the large lecture. I try to do several large lectures a year. And we get good turnout. They're voluntary. Nobody has to come. But I'm a bit of an entertainer. I'm a bit of a stand-up comedian. And I get them to come in and teach them something that they didn't think about the same way. And when they walk out, I want them to take that with them. I'm a bit of a cynic. I don't believe everything in medicine that I read. And I read the medical literature voraciously and professionally. And I like to get that little bit of cynicism in there so that they think about what they're doing and about what they're believing. The most valuable thing I do professionally and the most valuable thing to myself personally that I do is being the faculty member for the Emergency Medicine Interest Group. We're by far a very, very popular group on campus. We get loads of people into our meetings, even master's students, that want to learn more about what to do in an emergency. And we are a really good group because we go off campus. Every year I take a bunch of our students to Luzerne County Community College, put a t-shirt on them and say, you're a paramedic student tonight. And for 3 hours, they go through the testing stations that my paramedic students go through. And they learn to really, really understand how difficult it is to be a paramedic. And they learn emergency techniques that they wouldn't have otherwise learned for years, that they wouldn't otherwise do in the hospital. They get out great things about cardiac resuscitation, pediatric resuscitation, even plain old ambulance stuff, like how do you get somebody out of a car, onto a gurney, or onto a backboard, and safely put them in the ambulance. That is not usually taught in medical school. I didn't learn that in medical school. I learned that teaching paramedics. And that's what I want my kids to be. I want them to be paramedics in their brain. TCMC is a phenomenal institution because it's young, it's scrappy. They have people like me that do this for free. I'm not in this for anything except the joy of doing it and the joy of seeing students evolve into doctors.